This is Taurus Launch Control. With us in the Mission Director Center is Chuck Dovale. He is our Assistant Launch Director tonight and also the Deputy Director of the Launch Services Program for NASA. And Chuck, can you explain exactly what happened? What did the launch team see that didn't give them confidence to proceed into that last 5 minutes?
Okay, well, I'll give it a shot. The team is actually still working out to try to understand what the issue was. There's a set of GSE ground support equipment called the Vehicle Interface Control Console that basically controls and provides status of the launch vehicle systems, configuration they're in, whether it's safe or not. And it appears that a hold fire condition was noticed, which basically means a safe condition was sent. The curious part of that is the vehicle was already safe, so something external, it was an external signal that indicated that the vehicle should be safe, so we didn't quite understand why we were getting that indication. The VIC, the Vehicle Interface Control Console, there is a backup unit to it. The team quickly adjusted to the backup, but we're getting the same indications as the prime, so it clearly wasn't an indication of just a piece of GSE that went bad. I think the biggest problem is the issue occurred at about L minus 12 minutes or so, and with basically no room for any flexibility of a long window. We just ran out of time for troubleshooting. Troubleshooting is continuing. We had to make sure we understood the vehicle configuration and that we could get it safed. We're in the process of doing that. Troubleshooting is commencing. We don't understand the problem at the moment. I can just tell you that we're going to troubleshoot it in the next few hours. And we certainly won't continue until we understand it. We are posturing for a 24-hour turnaround in the event that we can find a root cause and hopefully try again tomorrow.
Now, does this system, is it monitor only, or does it actually affect the ability to command the vehicle one way or the other?
Yeah, it provides control. So when the vehicle goes from a safe to an arm condition, this is the equipment that's providing that. It's in the launch equipment van. So like I said, we were in a safe mode, and it externally received a signal to go into the safe mode, and we don't quite understand why that had occurred. So
it would affect our ability to properly command the vehicle in those last few minutes or few seconds of the flight.
Right, absolutely.
And we weren't getting the proper indication that this was working as it should.
Yeah, there was no indication the count was smooth, we had just cleared. The biggest problem was a boat in the drop box, this just kind of cropped up. The team out near the site got an indication that a safe command was sent, a hold fire command was issued. And that's just timing-wise, that was not, a proper indication to get at that point.
So that just didn't give us confidence that we would have full control of the vehicle in that last few minutes.
Right. If you don't understand what this VIC, the ground support equipment is doing,
again, it's called the vehicle.
There's really no
vehicle.
No need to just continue on until you understand it.
It's called Vehicle Interface
Control console
is what is the unit that they'll be troubleshooting over the next several hours.
Right.
All right. Chuck, thank you for coming over, and we'll just stand by for further details as we get them.
Okay.
But right now, I guess we'll plan to proceed toward a launch attempt again tomorrow night.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Chuck Dovale, our assistant launch director on the status of the countdown and the issue that we began to work in the last few minutes of the countdown. This is Taurus Launch Control.